Ladies and gentlemen, good morning to you. Could I ask you to give a round of applause there for our wonderful entertainers? Namely, Caoimhe Scanlon, Clodagh Murphy, Aideen Quinlan, and they all are representing the Listowel branch of Ceoltas Ceoltóirí Éireann under the guidance of Mr. John Stack. Thank you. Last Cathaoirleach of Kerry County Council, Cathaoirleach of Listowel Municipal District, deputies, senators, councillors, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who don't know me, and I think I probably know a lot of you at this stage, but my name is Joan McCarthy, and I work in the tourism unit in Kerry County Council, and I'm your MC this morning. Farin Faltes fe heroiv goleir, golistuhul, agus gosiola plan ganiv, agus strateis turashorakta kiri, strateis ahugan fish turashorakta den skotta kiri. I would like to welcome you all to my own hometown, lovely Listowel, and to a very special place, St. John's Theatre and Arts Centre. Unfortunately, our Minister of State cannot be with us this morning due to an unforeseen appointment, and he sends his apologies. Today has to be said that it is a very important and a big day for Kerry, with the launch of the County Kerry Tourism Strategy and Action Plan. There is no doubt that it is a very ambitious plan, and even if we succeed in delivering 75% of our actions, we will be achieving an awful lot. But this strategy will help to ensure that Kerry is in the best possible place to capitalise on the projected growth for the tourism industry in Ireland, and also to capitalise on the capital grant scheme through Fall to Ireland, and also on the Leader Rural Development Programme. I would like to thank all that who play their part in bringing the strategy to this stage. The Destination Kerry Tourism Forum, who are here today, the state bodies, both local and national, the tourism bodies in Kerry, and in particular the local communities who gave of their time and energy to inform this plan. Also to the chairs of the members of the working groups who met on several occasions and presented extensive reports at the end of the process. All of your valuable contributions and collaboration will help to ensure that Kerry retains its position as lead tourism county in our country. I would now call on the chairperson of the Tourism, Culture, Arts and Recreation, SPC, Councillor Robert Beasley, to address you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being with us today. As Chair of Tourism, Culture, Arts and Recreation Strategic Policy Committee, I am delighted to be here today at the formal launch of the Kerry County Tourism Strategy and Action Plan. Nurturing support and protecting the people, communities and organisations which are well spring for the authentic expression of culture, theatre, storytelling and literature, and of course the Irish language, is a strategic priority of the strategy. We know from FI research that our visitors enjoy and appreciate real authentic experience where they can engage in a meaningful way with our culture and our people. Inclusive and accessible activities and facilitate all provide our visitors with first-class experience and ensure the long-term sustainability of our products. Festivals and events are also an integral part of what our county has to offer as a holiday destination and afford an opportunity for local businesses and communities to attract and increase visitors and revenue. They also provide opportunities to showcase our culture, people and place, and I commend all of the voluntary effort involved in the huge organisation of the various events and festivals held in Kerry throughout the year. Through the financial assistance of FI, Kerry County Council's Community Support Fund and the Leader Programme operated by the local development companies, organisations can continue to build on current festivals and introduce further events to our calendar over our coming years. With us all working together, I have no doubt that progress on some of our actions will be delivered in the short term. Míle bíochas. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll now call on Ms. Myra Morrell, Chief Executive of Kerry County Council, to address you.
Good morning, and I just want to say thank you so much for making the journey for many of you to Listowel this morning. I suppose we're in Ireland's tidiest small town, and I hope maybe someday soon, next year, the year after, we'll be in Ireland's tidiest town, and you can join with the illuminaries out there of Killarney, Kinmare and Sneem. What a county and what achievement. The I suppose the tourism strategy today, I'm very proud to have a day like today where we have a launch today and where we have people right across the county. And I think seeing people right across at the county of Kerry, north, south, east and west come today is testament that this isn't a strategy that has come top down. It's not a strategy that has has come from of course it ties in with national policy, but it hasn't come from a national body. It hasn't come through any other way other than from the communities up. And I want to really thank the people who have contributed hugely to this report. When I think of, we've had well over 12 months of consultation out there, and sometimes consultation and people's eyes kind of glaze over when we mention consultation. But this has been really our people out meeting people in communities, talking to people about how they see tourism, where they see the priorities and where they see this going over the next few years. And really, when you see this plan, it's not one for the faint-hearted. And the members of Kerry County Council in adopting this plan have adopted a very ambitious plan for the county. And it really is the ambitions and the priorities of the county that's feeding in here. I suppose one of the things we wanted when we were developing this plan is that we didn't want the lingo. We wanted it to say what it was saying. We didn't want a fancy plan. You'll find a lot fancier plans than you'll find in that. However, what you'll see is a lot of plain actions laid out very plainly with targets and people assigned to deliver them. And that's the way it should be, because this plan is to be delivered. It's hugely ambitious. Maybe not all of it will be delivered, but we'll make every effort as a county to deliver as much as we can of this plan over the period. The plan is a moving plan. Things will change and things will shift and things will fall off and things will add on, because that's the kind of county we are. You know, we're a county, we're constantly hungry, we're constantly trying to achieve and we're constantly on the go, and we have huge ambition for ourselves as a county, and I think that plan needs to reflect that. One of the things as well in developing this plan that was very important to it was that it was grounded in research. And I suppose when we went out, we found that there was quite a lot of research out there. Maybe, you know, we started the plan and maybe the view was there wasn't quite a lot of research done in the county around the tourism sector. And through a lot of extensive, I suppose, discussion with Fault Ireland and other bodies, there's quite a lot of research done on tourism. But I suppose one of the things, there hasn't been quite a lot of research done specifically on Kerry. So I think, you know, in looking at where our priorities and where we need to drive ourselves, we need to understand what's driving the tourism product in Kerry. And I think from this strategy, we can say, well, okay, you know, we know we've 1 million overseas visitors coming into the county year on year. We know most of those come from North America. We know a share of them come from the European market. And we also have a share, even though it's declining, from the UK. We know we've 50,000 bed nights in Kerry, and we have more or less the largest number of bed nights outside of the greater Dublin region. We know we've 1 in 5 people employed in tourism, so this isn't a nice to have. This is a critical industry, a critical driver for the county, and we should never forget that. We also know that 20% of the people who come here to visit family and friends, 70% of people come here to holiday, and 10% come here on business. We also know that 75% of those people who come to the county come between May and October. So therefore, it's saying a few very strong messages to us which have directed the actions coming out of this plan. There's capacity in the domestic market. Our share of the domestic market is declining as a county. So therefore, one of the key strategies for Kerry going forward is to work very closely with Fault Ireland around our domestic market and messaging around the domestic market, and the domestic market to fill in before May and after October, because we know that's where 75%, we know we've capacity on either end of those. We know we have the bed nights. 10% of people come here to do business. So we know we have huge capacity there. We know we have bed nights, We know when people come here, we've plenty for them to do. We know business is a year-round type of tourism, and we know we have the Kerry Convention Bureau. So I think targeting funding, targeting investment, really, I suppose, putting the county behind the work of the Kerry Convention Bureau is a sensible thing to do when you see the research that's laid before us. Access to the county, hugely important when you see the potential growth in the area. Support for Kerry Airport, growing Kerry Airport, growing the routes from Kerry Airport into the European mainland makes absolute sense for us. Linking up with Shannon, having strategic alliances with Shannon Airport, where people can fly right into the Wild Atlantic Way, and having some kind of joined up thinking with counties along the Western Seaboard, for that makes absolute sense, as we can see what's driven from the strategy. We also know, looking at the strategy, that we have to tackle this idea of seasonality. We are at capacity during the height of the season, but we also have these very slack periods on either side. We know 1 in 5 in our people work in tourism. We know it has huge potential to be a meaningful employer, to keep families in the rural areas, which is what this is about. We know that whole community tourism is an area of huge growth and huge potential for us. So, you know, you'll find quite a lot said about that in our strategy. We talk a lot about branding and messaging in our strategy. Obviously, we have to be in line with the national message. We have to be in line with the Wild Atlantic Way, which we, I think, is well accepted as a very, very good brand and a very good message out there at the moment. And we have to, as a county, send our message and our brand out there, working with that. And there's a lot of work through Joan McCarthy happening at the moment in the county around the messaging. And we want a message to say that tourism is economic, is an economic driver. It's a huge economic driver for us. So the message must be equal, whether you're coming here from with a tourism hat on or you're coming here to invest. Kerry is the place to come. It's a modern economy with all the great things that a county like Kerry has to offer. Sustainability is at the heart of this strategy. Everything we do in this county has to be about sustainability. We've over half our county designated in some way or other with an environmental designation. So every single thing we do, we have to be sustainable. It's about protecting what we have and growing with it and being cognizant of it. So you'll find very much the focus here around adventure tourism. You know, it fits very well with the kind of county we have. It's a very sustainable, it's using our natural resources. We talk about our environment, culture and heritage. These are things we have in spades. Look where we're based this morning. You know, you talk about culture. It's about developing trails. It's about using the products we have and growing them some more. We talk a lot about community tourism events. We have in the order, I think at this stage, well over 200 events and festivals going on almost without any acknowledgement in the county. And yet that's such an enriching experience for any visitor coming to our county year on year. So, you know, that's something when you see, and I'm delighted this morning to see representation from other voices, when you take such a niche kind of festival and the reach that has to the world out there, and when you see the potential of that and what it can do for the reputation of the county, these are the kind of festivals, along with the much loved and the strong festival brands we have with the Rose of Tralee and so on. This is the place, these are the places we need to go. We talk about enterprise and innovation. We talk about education. And, you know, as part of that, the whole education and tourism education. We have within the regional action plan for jobs in the southwest region between Cork and Kerry. We talk about developing a centre of excellence for tourism. You know, I think that's something we all need to take on board very, very seriously. Again, it's about building our reputation, building our brand in this whole tourism sector. So I just want to say, I suppose just outside of that, I want to really, really thank everybody, and I know everybody and nobody, but I want to thank everybody in the county for taking the whole new trust of tourism and the whole new bottom-up approach of tourism so seriously. When I look at Destination Kerry and take it as a representative body of the tourism business interests in the county, it's chaired by the former Secretary General, Brendan Toohey, who will speak after me, who's been a fantastic and a great friend to this county and has done so much work as part of this strategy and as part of the group in bringing the group together, keeping us very focused and linking us very much to the outside agencies and the outside world and ensuring we're looking out as opposed to looking in, which is so critical for the future of tourism in the county. I want to thank the chair of the Tourism SPC. I want to thank the members of Kerry County Council who are represented on Destination Kerry, Fault Ireland, the hotel representatives, the MPWS, local employers, development company sector, whom we're working very, very closely with, and I see here this morning represented, Udrós na Gaeltachta, Enterprise Network, I see Mary here this morning, Chamber Groups, I see Killarney is very well represented here in Tralee this morning as well. Thank you so much for coming up. The support is hugely appreciated. And I see the third level sector, Mary Rose Stafford, who's a member of Fault Ireland Board, is also part of our Destination Kerry group. So I think it's a sign of people working together. It's not one sector in the county. And when you see that the type of potential that we have for tourism in the county, it's so important that these everybody in the county is working together with the one aim and the one objective. And this is what this is really about, very simply this morning. It's about the county having one aim and one objective and one way of getting there. We might all have our own ins and outs, and we might pull and drag at one another at different times and have our own tiffs and arguments. But at the end of the day, it's about delivering that plan is what's really, really important. And I think that to see the number of people who've turned out here this morning is testament to the amount of consultation and the amount of engagement and the amount of inclusion that has happened over the last 12 to 18 months. And I really do want to acknowledge that very seriously. In conclusion, look, I do want to say a special thank you to Fault Ireland. I want to thank Orla and Fiona Monaghan and Josephine and Declan. You've been a huge support, and really there isn't any day that we have any issue or any direction or anything that we want to discuss that we haven't found a friend in Fault Ireland. And I think it's very important that I acknowledge that on behalf of the County Kerry. And I suppose in conclusion as well, I'd like to thank very much Joan McCarthy, John Griffin, and the tourism unit in Kerry County Council. And I think it's been one of the very successful things that has come out of the reorganisation of local government. I think the fact we have a designated tourism unit, I see huge benefit. And I'm sure in the implementation of this plan, we'll all see the benefits. So thank you very much for the big turnout this morning. I really do appreciate it.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, before Riverdance, there was Siom Satira. Another round of applause, please, for Siom Satira. Our next speaker is the chairperson of Kerry Destination Kerry Tourism Forum, a Cork man. And you know yourselves, it isn't often we go over the border for advice, but we got a great man in Brendan Toohey, and we are absolutely delighted to have him as part of our team in tourism. He has been an inspiration, and his work ethic is absolutely immense. Over to you, Brendan.
Joan was charming as ever. When I saw them coming out dancing, I was getting really worried that she doesn't expect me to go up and do it for your sake rather than and for my sake. Sitting in coming to a church, a beautiful church here this morning, sort of reminds me of the two priests coming out of the Waldorf Astoria in New York, where they had that famous dinner last night, where any of you have read it in the paper this morning, with the two presidential candidates. And one priest said to the other, "That was a fantastic conference on poverty." And the other guy says, "Yeah, I can't wait for the one on celibacy." I think the chief executive, Mara Morell, has covered in really aptly the sort of challenges that we were faced on this developing the strategy. This isn't your normal strategy. Government and local government probably, but particularly government, is brilliant at producing documents and strategies. And that seems to be the end. That's the terminus. It's not the... In this case, the strategy is the departure lounge. It's not the terminus. It's a starting point. And with this, we've included in it the action plan at the back. And as Maura Morell said, this isn't a written in stone. This is a moving document, but this is the first cut at it, and to get things underway. A lot of things, I think as a country, we have a great tradition of doing documents and doing strategies and papers, and that's it then, we think the job is done. So one of the great things about this has been the process to get there. General Eisenhower in the Second World War, on one occasion said, "Plans are useless, but planning is everything." And I think today, it's that planning that we've been through, that process of being through. Bottom-up engagement. It's taken a bit longer than we envisaged originally, but it's been well worth it because there's buy-in. You just look around the room today and you see there's buy-in. So in that sense, the process of getting here has been very important, and we've set the seeds, I think, for the next phase, which is that commitment and sort of a willingness to succeed that people want. Second thing, I suppose, that strikes me about some of the challenges, and Maura has referred to them, but built around this, Kerry's been very successful. I think every other county in the country will give the right arm to be where Kerry's at on the tourist scene. And you sort of ask yourself, well, why bother? So if everyone else thinks we're the best, why bother? You're doing it because things are changing. There's a huge market out there. There's a huge global market. Ireland as a country, we've set ourselves a target of increasing by 20-25%, going up to about 10 million visits by tourists, foreign tourists, by 2025. That's a very significant amount. We're talking about increasing the number, not just the number of tourists, but particularly the value that they bring. And you're doing that against a backdrop that sterling has almost gone to parity with the euro in the last few weeks. So that's a challenge. These are headwinds that we never expected. Well, sorry, we've written them into the document, but they've come on probably much faster than we thought. So it's this idea about being prepared for the future. The future is a social construct. The future isn't a place you're going to sail into. You can make it happen by talking about it, by being prepared for it. And I think what Kerry has been doing is preparing its strategy and saying, we want to have a say in what happens in the future. These are our views. Morris talked about the importance of access, air access in particular, I think, and maybe sea access, but particularly air access. At the moment, most tourists are coming through Dublin. And that's a challenge. That's a challenge for the durability and the sustainability of, say, the West Coast broadly. We listened this morning to some fantastic music and some dance. Again, just a tip of the iceberg of what's available in Kerry. When we talk about sustainability, we talk about the physical environment and the protection of that and the environment side. And we talk about the opportunities that are there, as long as we look after it. And that we see the importance of that today. But I'd make a special plea on the nurturing the cultural and the sort of linguistic heritage. Martin O'Kine, the Galway poet, described the west coast of Ireland as the Cuinne an Ghaoire to the Irish language and culture. The Cuinne an Ghaoire is the corner, the hare's corner, where they didn't cut the parts of the field to allow the hare to continue to live there. And he's right. This is the Cuenya Angaria, and this is an integral part of this. But we're a great country for rolling people out for events, and then we expect them to continue to exist throughout the rest of the year. So I make this sort of plea more to government, probably, but also maybe to the local government, and say that we've really got to sustain and look after the type of musicians and the younger people coming through there to make sure that this isn't just a once event, once a year, we roll them out for the events, that we look after them. And part of the tourism strategy isn't just about attracting tourists. They come here for a whole lot of reasons, but one of the key reasons they come here, the environment, but also that cultural element. And our job is to sustain that, and that's what sustainability is, to nurture that. And the other side of that then is when we look to the future of where the jobs, Maura has talked about the challenge, we've about 20% of the people in Kerry work in the tourism sector. The OECD, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, published a report earlier this summer, and they said 65% of young people today are going to work in jobs that don't exist today. Let me run that past you again. 65% of young people today are going to work in jobs that don't exist today. So the jobs of the future are not what we've grown up with. And the challenge we have is to prepare the environment for that. So the tourism, what we do on tourism about creating and sustaining the local environment, making it a nice place to live, that feeds into, I suppose, what today is called social capital. It's the place where people come, where do people live in an area. If you can do business anywhere in the world, it's the quality of the local environment becomes important. The quality of the physical environment, the quality of the cultural environment, the educational environment, and just the feeling of being in a place. So the paradox of globalization is that the local becomes more important. And I think today, as we look at tourism, we just don't look at about the numbers of people going to come in here. This is really about creating that environment of which tourism is an integral part, and we'll go right across what, say, the local government is doing here, and maybe the state agencies as well. And just before finishing, one of the great things we, I suppose, my experience of dealing with the Destination Kerry Forum was just the great local groups that we met, the individuals around the county, some fantastic people who are in their own area very committed to doing things and making things happen. And the challenge then that government has in the broader sense is taking the state agencies, getting these to talk together and say, okay, well, let's do things in Kerry. So put the hand up in Kerry, put it across Kerry and say, in our local community, we can do things. We're prepared to be a pilot or a test to do things. We've already seen some of that. And the benefits of that is everybody wants success. We want to see things happen. And ultimately, it's the kids coming up. I see it in some of the figures I've seen in parts of Kerry where there's no kids going into some of the local primary schools in the last September. And that's a challenge when you see that exodus. But if you think about that other sentence I said earlier about the number of jobs of the future that don't exist, part of the challenge then is by using tourism as a way of enhancing the local community and environment and building that sense of community and building it in a sustainable way, that makes it attractive for people to develop the type of jobs we're talking about and where they can locate anywhere now with the right type of technology. So in conclusion, the challenge, I think, and Maura's averted to it, is not just writing the strategy. Anybody could sit down here and write a strategy. Getting the buy-in to that strategy. And the challenge for the council, I think, now is going to be implementation. And you will be measured, the county council will be measured on delivery. And so I think anyone who's interested then is to give that support to the county council. So I would look forward to seeing what happens and working with the various groups over the next year to see implementation of that big series of action plans at the back there. So thanks very much, and it was a real privilege and pleasure to be involved.
Thank you, Brendan. As you're all no doubt aware, Listowel is known in North Kerry, of course, steeped in a literary tradition and culture, and well known for it, I think, worldwide at this stage. The late, great Brian McMahon, playwright, novelist, and short story writer, played a huge role in placing Listowel as the literary capital of Ireland and is also one of the most prominent writers whose work is celebrated annually in our very successful Writers' Week. Today I'm delighted to introduce to you his equally talented son, Owen. Owen has acted and produced many plays here in St. John's with the award-winning Listowel Drama Group. He has a huge passion for his native town and his county and all things Irish. Please welcome Mr. Owen McMahon, who will recite I Am of Kerry by Sigerson Clifford. Thank you.
Just a few small words and thoughts that came through me as the speakers were there. Myra mentioned that the Wide Atlantic Way was a wonderful motto and a wonderful trademark. I'll give you one, Myra. Four lines my father composed some time ago. I bid you men remember then the lovely hills of home, the mountain brown o'er Dingle Town, Valentia on the foam, the river Feel and sweet Tralee, Killarney's heavenly plan, for none can beat the kingdom sweet for hound or horse or man. Secondly, taking up the point that Brendan said, and reflecting also that I was very thankful that I wasn't asked to dance, because early in my career, when I thought I was the bee's knees, I met a lady at a Siege of Venice, a great character in the town called Babe Jo Wilmot, known to everybody here, and I met her in a Siege of Venice. I was 25, she was 65. And when we parted, after giving a twirl around the floor, she said, I didn't take a lot of your dancing, Mr. McMahon. And I said, why, babe? For all the world, she says, you remind me of a dog pissing. I should have kept my mouth shut, but I asked her why. You always seem to have one leg in the air, she says. I also want to be associated with what Joan said there, that we did have Shiamsa, a project very dear to my father's heart, long before we had Riverdance in this county, and we were proud to have it. Another thought came to me, Brendan, when you spoke about our cultural heritage. I'll read you a few lines, and then I'll tell you who wrote it. It's about our culture, thoughts about our Irish language. Not to learn Irish is to miss the opportunity of understanding what life in this country has meant and could mean in a better future. It is to cut oneself off from ways of being at home. If we regard self-understanding, mutual understanding, imaginative enhancement, cultural diversity, and a tolerant political atmosphere as desirable attainments, we should remember that a knowledge of the Irish language and culture is an essential element in their realization. Written by the Nobel Peace Prize winner, Seamus Heaney. And I think that reflects very much what we're talking about. We forgive you, Brendan, that you come from Cork. Because John B. wrote that being a Kerryman, in my opinion, is the greatest gift God can bestow on any man. When you belong to Kerry, you know you have a head start on the other fellow. In belonging to Kerry, you belong to the elements, to the spheres spinning in the heavens. You belong to history and language, culture, romance, and ancient song. It's almost unbearable being a Kerryman, and it's an awesome responsibility. I had a quick run through this in 5 seconds, as any solicitor would do. He only gets to the bottom line, so I started at page 103. And it again resonated with me, because in the last week, I met two visitors from Twickenham, outside London, in the golf club in Ballybunion, sitting on their own, and I decided to engage them. And here, on page 103, the statement is, in Kerry, tourism is everybody's business. Every interaction with a tourist is an opportunity to make them feel welcome, sell and promote the destination, its attraction and businesses. I spent a half an hour with them, and I'm sure they went on their way a little bit lightened of heart, because I told a few jokes, but I also was able to direct them where to go and where not to go. And it is, you can produce your plans, but if every individual doesn't implement it, then, as my father would say, paper never refused ink. We all have to implement it.
The last thing is we here in Kerry are very fortunate to live here in Kerry, and the story goes of the Valencia man who was never outside of Kerry, but was going to his first All-Ireland in the train with his friend. And Mick was looking at the countryside as it was passing by. And as the train went through the Curra and the flatlands of the Curra, and Mick being used to the mountains of Carntuil, Mick turned to his friend Pat and he says, he saw the Curra and there was only one house there. And he said to his friend Pat, "Pat, some people live very far away." So we are sure that this is the center of our universe. Sigerson Clifford captured it, and maybe I will be forgiven if I recite this, and then I will just leave you with a song which I'll introduce afterwards because it mentions a lot of places in Kerry. Sigerson Clifford, "I Am Kerry." I am Kerry like my mother before me and my mother's mother and her man. Now I sit on an office stool, remembering, and the memory of them like a fan soothes the embers into flame. I am Kerry and proud of my name. My heart is looped around the rutted hills that shoulder the stars out of the sky, and about the wasp yellow fields and the strands where the kelp streamers lie, where, soft as a lover's Gaelic, the rain falls, sweeping into silver the lacy mountain walls. My grandfather tended a turf fire, and leaning backward into legend spoke of doings old before quills inked history. I saw dark heroes fighting in the smoke. Dear my dead inside, he's Ivara Cave and Deirdre queening upon Nisha's grave. I see the wise face now with its 100 wrinkles, and every wrinkle held a 1,000 tales of Finn and Oscar and Conan Moyle, and sea-proud Nile, whose conquering sails raiding France for slaves and wine brought Patrick to mind Milcu's swine. I should have put a noose around the throat of time and choked the passing of the hobnail years and stayed young always, shouting in the hills where life held only fairy fears. When I was young, my feet were bare, but I drove cattle to the fair. 'Twas this I lived, skin to skin with the earth, elbowed by the hills, drenched by the billows, watching the wild geese making black wedges by Skellig's far west and on a skull of the willows. Their voices came on every little wind, whispering across the half door of the mind, for I am always Kerry. Auron, Chum, Graher, Garin, Achmarn. Auron, Fui, Balachyonter, Irikiri, Inakele, and Fraudballa, and Voltin, Ubadan Terig. Art, Aka, Gary, could more drama, learn to see Marvi, Tiggy, and Bug here. Art, Ata, Inakele, Kyon Chibale, Kyon Chibale, and Art, and Avi, Winter, and Skonan. Star Wars, Imliana, agus an tiddle atá ar an órán ná my home and got to do. As I cross the bridge of Blennerville and turn my face back west, my pulse it races faster and my heart beats in my breast. I'm back in Cork Aguina now, my rambling days all through. On the road to Ballyferriter, and my home in Gortadoo. Through camp I go, and Lounagalt, and far fame down a skull. And I think of Crean of Antarctica, where Scott the Brave did fall. I'm near my goal, when I reach Lisbon, soon Dingle Bay's in view. On the last leg of my journey, and my home in Gortadoo. When I pass the Boer Father, and I stop at Monaghan, where Mount Brandon stands in high command above the sisters three, the Firs are yellow bonfire against the purple heather's hue, and through misty eyes I recognize my home in Gortadu. Ta gaelin bwyn a lawrt o'ch i mi elmyn i nawn. Cydacta gagos cwrs yn o'ch cilwr o'ch sport is grawn. An londra fys yn smol o'ch hyd eich sgapel e'n is cwma. Tam yr is im lam o oige sme i rasna gorta dua. As I watched the autumn slanting sun set by my cottage door, fun car tarts come coursing through my vines, of friends I'll see no more. So lay me down in Dunorland, midst my neighbours kind and true, where one and all will wait God's call from my home in Gortadu. So raise your glass, each lad and lass, and raise a toast with me to each hill and vale around Countshibale, to Dunchin by the sea. My heart's desire, to which I aspire, I'll now relate to you. May I live to see old Ireland free from my home in Gortadu. Come on.
What a way to spend a Friday morning, huh? Yes. Before I call on the next speaker, I'd like to tell you all about a little about this fabulous theatre that we're in this morning. The building was actually gifted to the people of the Stole in the 80s by the Church of Ireland. A local voluntary committee took on the big task of developing this little theatre back in 1988, and it actually cost £250,000, which was raised by donations far and wide. It was completed in 1990. So since then, St John's has become hugely successful, hosting around 80 theatre productions, 60 music and dance events, and 20 exhibitions annually. It draws audiences from all over Kerry, West Limerick and Cork. And I think it is a fantastic example of what a local committee and state authorities coming together can produce. It is of course managed by the very talented, the very professional and the extremely dedicated Mr. Joe Murphy. Yeah, that's you, Joe. Otherwise known as Vicar Joe. The Arts Council and Kerry County Council support the centre financially, and it is an extremely important part of our tourism offering here in North Kerry. It is a huge success story, and that is in no small way to, I think, the local committee here, and I would ask you to give them a round of applause again. For something like St John's to grow and to prosper and to have the door open almost seven nights a week, I think it is due to hard work, perseverance and dedication of that local committee. And I know our own Owen McMahon is a member of that committee. And Joe, of course, puts in endless hours to make sure that it all works. So it's a fantastic cooperation. I now call on the last Cathaoirleach of Kerry County Council, Councillor Liam Fertel, to formally launch our strategy.
Aguina Ishla. My wife spent 5 minutes this morning getting me to pronounce that properly, so I hope I have it right. As last Cathaoirleach of Kerry County Council, I am delighted to be here with you in this beautiful St John's Theatre in Listowel this morning to formally launch the Kerry Tourism Strategy and Action Plan. I am deputising today for the Cathaoirleach, Michael O'Shea, who sent his apologies. Michael is in London at a meeting with the Kerry London Association today. I would like to welcome all our guests, particularly our Chief Executive, Myra Morell, the staff of our Tourism Unit, the member of the Destination Kerry Tourism Forum, and the many representatives of the tourism industry here in Kerry. I very much welcome the adoption of this Kerry County Tourism Strategy, which forms an integral part of Kerry County Council's Local Economic and Community Plan for 2016 to 2022. This strategy has been informed by Kerry community sector, the state sectoral bodies, government departments, Kerry County Council and the Destination Kerry Tourism Forum. Continual partnership, which has been at the heart of the formulation of the strategy, will help to ensure its implementation, and I would like to thank everyone involved for their input and commitment to this ambitious strategy and action plan. During the lifetime of this strategy, new challenges, changing market trends and consumer behaviour will be continually assessed and actions updated as required. The delivery of the strategy objectives will be reviewed by the Tourism, Culture, Arts and Recreation Strategy Policy Committee and by Kerry County Council in accordance with the Local Economic and Community Plan Review. Kerry County Council and its members will not be found wanting in ensuring this is a living document, informing our approach to tourism policy in the county in the years ahead. Sustainably is the key to effectively growing our tourism product, and any future developments and actions must be sustainable, safeguarding the natural built cultural and linguistic heritage of our country, which have always been the foundation stones of our tourism industry. I want to publicly acknowledge the role of the Tourism, Cultural, Arts and Recreation Strategy Policy Committee under its chairman, my friend and colleague, Councillor Robert Beasley, and also the staff of Kerry County Council for their commitment and enthusiasm in this, bringing this plan to fruition. I have no doubt that through the delivery of this strategy, the whole county will have a stronger, sustainable tourism industry, which will ensure job creation and greater prosperity for the citizens of our beautiful county. I invite you all to play your own role in ensuring its implementation, and I have no doubt that the same collaborative approach which led to the formation of this plan will also see its successful implementation. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Councillor Quirtle. To conclude our proceedings this morning, I would like to thank you all again for coming. I would like to thank our talented entertainers, Kioltas Kioltairi Éireann, our local group, Siam Satira, and our wonderful Owen McMahon. Thank you to all of them. Now, I would also like to thank Falter Ireland for their continued support on behalf of the tourism unit. I would like to thank my own staff for the huge amount of work they put into the strategy and organising this morning. And I know one shouldn't actually name anyone individual, but I have to absolutely thank John Griffin. I came into the tourism unit knowing very little about tourism, and all I can say is that I've learned a lot since. Thank you, John. Now, we have some refreshments. I'd like you to join us. And I would also like to thank profusely St. John's for the use of this beautiful theatre this morning. And Lizzie's Little Kitchen, actually, I'd like to highlight, is doing the food for us this morning. Lizzie is a great success story in Listowel. She's a native, and she started off here on a Friday morning in the farmer's market. It was always her ambition to have her own little restaurant. She had worked in the UK in hospitality and catering. And she has now gone from the farmer's market to having a pop-up in Ballybunion in 2015, which remained open actually during the off-season. And this summer we're delighted that Lizzie opened another restaurant here in Listowel. She's very much into healthy eating and healthy food, and I think it is a great addition to the tourism offering here in North Kerry. So I hope you enjoy your samples of her beautiful food, and thank you all again for coming.
So yeah, glad to be part of this great occasion. I look forward to the implementation of the strategy. I think it offers a great opportunity for the county and will strengthen its position at the forefront of tourism in the country.
Well, first of all, being involved with Cappin Lee, I'd like to say I'm delighted that is highlighted so much. And it corresponds with our own strategic plan that we're developing at the moment. Obviously, I was just saying to Valerie O'Sullivan, or trying to say to her, that both my parents came from the two sides of the reek, so I got my love of the mountains by being on my uncle's farm. So obviously I look forward to development, the right development of the reeks, and respecting local landowners and all the rest. So that's part and parcel of the strategy, and look forward to seeing it happen.
You know, the wider adventure activities are so prominent within the plan. Kerry has so much to offer for its green environment, it's the challenging mountains, the rugged coastline, all these things get the rightful prominence in a plan, and they will play a big part in the future of tourism in the county.
Morning here at Listowel Writers Week. Absolutely delighted, and delighted to see that the work that we've put into the strategy and all those meetings we attended over the last few months have come to fruition, and we look forward to implementing all the strategy in conjunction with Kerry County Council. And I think it's a very worthy document, and it is a very valuable piece of work. And I know that from our own perspective, Listowel Writers Week are looking forward to developing out-of-shoulder events and literary events around outside of the Listowel Writers Week, which we really look forward to, and they can be very easily implemented, so we're definitely going to work on doing that.
It's great to see the strategy being launched here today in Listowel. You know, Kerry's got a huge amount to offer. You know, there's a lot going on in the county at the moment. A number of different strategies being developed, especially around, I suppose, now like marine-based strategy and water-based activity. Down in South Kerry, there's a Blue Way strategy being developed, and we're looking at developing something similar in North Kerry. We have plenty of heritage and culture in the county as well, and we're trying to tie everything in, I suppose, between, you know, at the county level, where you're tapping into natural resources, the history of the area, the culture of the area, the heritage of the area, and making a better experience for a tourist arriving over to the county. Both domestic tourists and overseas visitors.
Pashing even then, so a geary, Errol O'Kite, so shoulder strategy to reserve the first shady goody, first the fair doors to them. It's wonderful to be here in Listowel, a wonderfully cultured place in North Kerry, a huge literary tradition, a fantastic arts and culture tradition, and it's part of a remarkable offering that this county offers to any tourist who wants to come this way. It's a gateway across the Shannon up to the other parts of Clare, up the Wild Atlantic Way to Galway, and then if you go west from here, through Tralee and out, as the song says, to Blennerville and Camp and on to Dingle. There are wonderful things that await you when you take that journey. It's great to be here.
I'm delighted to be here today at the launch of the Kerry Tourism Strategy. We're very excited about, I suppose, kicking off the new leader programme and the potential that is there to support and develop tourism projects around the county, especially focusing on, I suppose, the whole area of marine tourism and blue ways and green ways. So, I suppose we're looking at, I suppose, developing a collaborative approach to all of this, working with all the other agencies, I suppose, to deliver on tourism for the north, east and west Kerry area.
I very much welcome all of the cultural pieces in the document, because I think the heart and soul of the county is involved with the people, and the people are the culture. The way they speak, the way they greet, the way they welcome, the language that they use, and I suppose the unique cultural attributes in the broader sense that are found in this county, the language itself, hugely enriching in every way.
Morning is a great day. It's a celebration of a lot of hard work over the last 18 months in the completion and development of this new strategic focus for Kerry for tourism. Kerry are, as always, leading the way in terms of the strategic development of tourism, and we in Fáilte, Ireland, have been delighted to be part of this journey and to continue on the journey over the implementation phases now of the strategy up to 2022. I'd like to compliment Moira Murrell on her leadership and the tourism unit, with John Griffin and Joan McCarthy in leading this charge and addressing every aspect of tourism in Kerry, and I am very taken by the commitment that tourism is is everybody's business here in Kerry, and that's a great accolade, but also one that will need to be delivered on over the lifetime of the strategy.
I'm delighted to be here in the Stole this morning at the launch of this strategic document and operation plan for tourism. I was pleased to represent the Department of Arts, Heritage, Regional and Rural Gates of Affairs, but particularly the National Parks and Wildlife Service, and I chaired the Environmental and Heritage Subcommittee and got fantastic engagement from all the stakeholders in that area, and I want to compliment them and the staff of Kerry County Council for the work that they put into getting this plan together, and I look forward to playing my part with my colleagues in the Department and in the National Parks and Wildlife Service to implement all the actions, particularly those that have our name aside of them.